The right to love whomever we choose is something many of us take for granted, and for many the path is still tricky. But in the Cook Islands, your choice of love could land you in jail for up to 7 years. The country not only turned away from homosexual law reform, it appears to have hardened its resolve. Barbara Drever investigates the island's rocky road to change.
Our day has been amazing.
Yeah, like we've been waiting for this day for so long.
Such a long time, yeah.
A celebration of love. Surrounded by family and friends.
It turned out beautifully, so we really are blessed to be
here. Yeah, we are. Yeah.
This long-awaited day is everything these childhood sweethearts dreamed of.
When you come here, you see the beautiful environment, the smiling faces, and that's how we are marketed to the world. But you only have to poke a little hole. You don't have to go too deep to see that not all is good in paradise.
Ngarima George, a respected healer, hand-picked by his ancestors.
We make traditional medicines for those who need help.
Also a pastor, it's his Bible, his faith, which guides him.
People who are in need of prayer, because I'm a minister of the gospel, they come, we share the word, and I pray for them.
My faith to me is everything. It's about having hope, and for me that's important.
Religion is a big part of Valerie's life too.
When I'm in church, that 1 hour gives me time to actually reflect on different things.
Two people, two believers, one God. But which of them could be jailed because of who they love?
If the law is still there, well, I'm sorry, they got to go to prison.
From the late 1960s, the way of life here has been preserved in law, protecting people, but not all people, using an archaic piece of legislation. In 2022 in the Cook Islands, homosexuals face up to 7 years jail.
It's about equality. If you are a human being, then you should be treated the same under the law.
And it's about to get worse. At home with the Witchmans.
My family's everything. They've been with me since day one, and they've supported me through my whole journey.
A journey that hasn't been easy.
I always felt different. I always knew that I was unique.
That's because Valerie grew up as Valentino, assigned male at birth. School was tough.
There was the bullying, there was the taunting, almost daily. Why were people being so cruel?
The turning point came at Auckland University.
It was liberating. I saw all the colours of the rainbow and how you could be who you want to be or who you are.
And Valerie became that person, a lawyer drafting her country's youth policy, receiving an award from the Queen for championing her community's rights.
In our culture, love, kindness and respect. That's very strong.
Do you see that there would be good gay people who'd be imprisoned because of who they are?
People born gay, I don't believe that. That's the work of the devil. If the law declare, you have to go in prison because the law was established. I can't change that law.
A lot of Christians accept people for who they are. Why can't you?
To leave a woman and a woman is a sin. To leave a man is a sin. Promoting sin. And the penalty of sin is death, according to the word.
Grandfather, churchman, Like many here, Ngārima George doesn't want the country's laws changed for the gay community.
Sin being promoted more in the Cook Island these days than before. When you die, you want to go to where the fire, or when you die, you go to go to heaven?
It hurts me because it makes me feel like I'm a second class citizen. I'm not as good as everyone else.
Have you felt alone?
There have been instances in my life where I have felt alone.
And now a new battle looms, state versus church. The attempt to update the law has been opposed. A select committee recommending the penalties should extend to same-sex female relations too.
My message to the community is that we will not have any discriminatory articles or pieces in this legislation when it is finally put before Parliament.
But will reassurances from the Prime Minister be enough for a community going up against the powerful church?
There's a lot of darkness out there. There's a lot of hate, a lot of misunderstanding, and it's sort of just boiling under the radar.
Despite this, the Pride community here is rallying, supported by major businesses.
One day, hopefully soon, the legal issue will be a thing of the past.
Even the Queen's representative, Sir Tom Masters, is here. His wife, Lady Masters, a staunch and influential ally.
It breaks my heart. It breaks my heart. Because they are our children. They are children. Give them their freedom to walk on the street in the Cook Islands, to do what they want to do.
This goes to the heart of human rights and equality for all, and that's guaranteed under the Cook Islands Constitution. While New Zealand decriminalised homosexuality more than three decades ago, the debate here drags on with no end in sight.
And it's taking its toll.
I get a lot of requests from youth or members who are going through sort of dark times because their families don't accept them or they've been kicked out of home, suicidal tendencies, and even completed suicides.
Who's getting you through this?
For me, it's my partner. He's always been very reassuring to me, and I do feel safe with him.
Isaiah and Valerie want their love to be legal. They're not asking for marriage, just equality.
Everyone's free to love who they want to love.
Yeah.
And it's just sad that, fortunately, they don't get that opportunity right now.
Like we do.
For these newlyweds, their day will be long remembered. But Valerie and Isaiah feel forgotten. Theirs is a love story with an uncertain ending.
Well, Te Vai Matapō of the Cook Islands Religious Advisory Council told Sunday that the Bible is clear. Same-sex relationships go against the word of God. He says that God is not against individuals, but prohibited behaviour. The council has made its submission to the Parliamentary Select Committee.